अस्सलाम वालेकुम वरहमतुल्लाहि वबरकातुहू। वेलकम बैक क्लास 8 इन योर कंप्यूटर क्लास। आई होप यू ऑल आर गिविंग योर बेस्ट इन योर टेस्ट। बी डू गिव योर टेस्ट वेरी ऑनेस्टली। बी ऑनेस्ट टू योर सेल्फ एंड डोंट अटैच द इंटरनेट पिक्स। आई डोंट वॉन्ट टू डिस्क्लोज द नेम्स ऑफ दोज गर्ल्स हु डिड दिस। यू are not allowed to attach the internet pics. If you are willing to draw diagram, draw the diagram in your copy, capture it and attach it. Give your test very honestly and study hard. Okay, let's come to the chapter 6. Today we are going to study links and frames in HTML. You all have studied HTML in your previous class. So let us revise what is HTML. So what is HTML? What is the full form of HTML? HTML is hypertext markup language. Now what is hyper? Hyper is nothing but it is just a link, or it is a reference or link to where you have to navigate. Text is nothing but the data or information. So whatever the data that you want to be displayed, that information will be displayed in a form of text, markup. It is predefined statements present in this language. And language is used for communication. If you want to communicate, you need a language. So what is HTML? HTML is a hypertext markup language. What is this? This is hypertext markup language, and this language is used to create web pages. Okay. Now, markup, this language is not a programming language, it is a markup language. The markup language is a set of markup tags. This means these markup tags are used to design web page. Every page is designed in HTML has an extension. This HTML is saved with the extension .htm or .html. Every page is designed in HTML has an extension. It is saved in an extension .html or .htm. This is not a programming language. This is a markup language. To design this HTML web pages, we use Notepad. We do the coding of this language on Notepad, and then we save it with an extension .html or .htm. Clear? We use Notepad to write HTML language, and then we save it with an extension .html, and it will be executed in any web browser, in any web browser like Google Chrome, UC browser. Okay. So markup tags, you all have studied the basic tags of HTML, that is head, body, right? So first we study the structure of an HTML document. So first, the HTML document consists of the tag HTML. We write HTML. This is opening tag and this is closing tag. This is backslash. okay? This is opening tag and this is closing tag. So our first step to write any HTML code, we first write HTML. It indicates that this web page is written in HTML. And then what we write head. Okay? Head tag contains information about the web page. And then we give title. This is title tag. Title tag contains web page title. Okay? So suppose you want to give the title my house. This will be your title. And then we close this tag / title. Okay? Then we close the head. And then open body tag. In this body tag, it contains all the context of the web page. This body tag contains all the text, all the information which you want to display on your web page. After giving all the content, we close the body tag and then we close the HTML tag. This is the structure of any HTML code. We first start with HTML, then head, then we give title, then we close the head, then we open body, and here we give all the contents, all the information which you want to display on a web page, then we close the body, then we close the HTML. You all have studied this. I'm just recalling all those things. So you have studied these are basic tags. Now some of the tags are paragraph. You all have studied in your previous class. There is a paragraph tag, then body B, that is bold. If you want to write the text in bold, then we use B, right? Line break tag, that is written as BR, right? Line break tag. Let's discuss quickly some other useful tags. First is heading tag. It is denoted as H1. H1 is the highest level of heading. The heading tag, HTML can define up to 6 level of headings from H1 to H6. H1, H2, H3, H4, H5, H6. H1 is the first and the highest level of heading. H6 is the last and the smallest level of heading. It is a container tag because it has an ending tag. Suppose if you start with H1, then you will end with this / H1. So it is a container tag. Suppose you are giving here a heading, my first class. So this is your heading. Here is the opening tag and here is the closing tag. So this is a container tag. So heading tag is a container tag. Next is paragraph. The paragraph tag, it is written as small p. It is used to define the start and end of a paragraph in the text. It is a container tag starting with p and ending with / p. It is also a container tag. Then another tag is line break tag, which is written as small br. This is a line break tag and it is used when we want to start a new line. It is used when we want to start a new line but do not want to start a new paragraph. Then there is another tag, that is horizontal ruler tag. It is written as small hr. It is used to draw horizontal line between two paragraphs. It divides the web page into different sections. Then bold tag. This is written as a small b and it is used to give a bold effect to the text on a web page. It is a container tag starting with b and ending with backslash b. Then italic tag, it is used to give an italic effect on your web page. It is written as a small I and it is also a container tag. Then underline tag, it is written as a small u like this and it is used to underline the text on a web page. It is a container tag. So these are the basic tags which you have studied in your previous class. So what is HTML? HTML is a hypertext markup language. It is not a programming language. It is markup language because it contains markup tags. HTML is a basic computer language that is considered as a gateway to create websites. It is easy to learn and execute. So in the next class, we will discuss some interesting and useful HTML tags and their attributes for designing websites, inshallah. So read the chapter very thoroughly and revise it.